DCF would allow her to stay in hotels.
I don't think that DCF would let her stay in hotels.
Where they would not know where she was.
Well, I don't think they know where she is half the time anyways, but yes.
Is it your testimony that DCF was not aware she was missing?
What do you mean?
I mean, at some point, did it occur to you that DCF would file a missing persons report on a runaway?
Yeah, not... Well, you keep using the word runaway, but I didn't know that she would be able to run away.
You do not talk to any adult who is there. You get her as well as two of her friends who are also in DCF custody and underage. You put them in your car and you drive them 2.5 hours across the state back to your house.
They're 17 years old
objection
and they have no
answer.
Objection,
asked and answered. Overruled as to that objection.
They're 17 years old and they have an element.
You call DCF after you pick the girls up?
I wouldn't know who to call.
You wouldn't know how to get DCF's phone number?
I wouldn't know who to call.
Did you call law enforcement?
Why? They weren't running away.
The girls didn't have any bags with them, correct?
Well, and I didn't know that they were coming.
Did the girls have any bags with them?
No.
You never called the police at that point?
No, I was scared to death and I had my hands on the wheel because I was doing 80 miles an hour.
You never handed your phone to one of the two girls to call the police either?
No.
You didn't wave down the police as you were passing the accident?
He was taking care of an accident and I got by him, but I did pull over about maybe 50 feet after that, but
didn't you testify you were scared for your life?
I was.
But you didn't think that you needed to interrupt?
No, but I thought I could get up.
The question has to finish.
But you didn't think you should interrupt a police officer to tell him what was going on?
No, because I was past it already and they hadn't even stopped.
Who hadn't stopped?
The police had him stopped. Mr. Cole.
So now that you had...
So I got through and started driving. Okay, he got wrapped up into the accident. So I kept going.
So now that...
Now you're going to ask the question.
Wait, hold on.
So now that he's pulled over on the side of the road and you're in the presence of law enforcement... You didn't turn around and go back to tell the police what was going on, did you?
I did not.
You continued driving.
I did.
At excessive speeds?
No.
No?
No, because he was stuck back there.
Okay, and then once he got through, you continued driving at excessive speeds, correct?
Probably over the speed limit.
Probably?
Yeah, probably over the speed limit.
And then
it was a little teeny road. I didn't even know the road.
And then at some point, you drive through a T intersection
into a ditch.
Into a ditch.